Today on Schroeder TV, we'll be reviewing one of the newest additions in our catalog, where we have already been very successful in providing mobile filtration system solutions, as well as contamination monitoring solutions. We are now proud to offer all-in-one systems that can do both. Introducing the Mobile Filtration Systems, MFS-MFD, with the Hytrax Manual Fluid Sampling System option. This contamination monitoring device, added to our already powerful filtration systems, helps you manage both the current condition of your fluid, but also the actual filtration process. The combination of both best help to get your mineral-based oils to desired ISO contamination level. We not only offer the mobile filtration systems with this option included, but we also offer a retrofit option and instructions on how to add the Hytrax system to our already existing in-field mobile filtration system. Here at Schroeder Industries, we are always sharing our expertise of negative effects of contamination and degraded fluid quality. These issues cause inefficient operation, component wear, and eventually lead to failures in all hydraulic and lubrication systems. To best prevent fluid contamination and maintain equipment efficiency, we offer a varying selection of fluid conditioning products to best keep your precious machinery up and running at the machine's highest potential. Whether it be in cart, skid, or kidney loop system form, there's a Schroeder product ideal for the equipment you operate. We'll now venture into the topic of this video, our mobile filtration systems, the MFS and the MFD. The MFS and the MFD are compact, self-contained filtration systems equipped with high efficiency, high capacity elements that are capable of removing particulate contamination and/or water quickly, conveniently, and economically. The mobile filtration single, the MFS, includes one filter that can remove either water or particulate contamination based on your order specifications. The mobile filtration dual, the MFD, includes two filters that can be used to remove both water and particulate contamination, or it can be used as just a particulate removal only. Both units are perfect for cleaning up existing systems, as well as used for pre-filtering new mineral-based fluids. Since delivered, new fluids often have higher contamination and water content levels than the recommended ISO code for hydraulic systems. An MFS-MFD mobile filtration system is your ideal solution for pristine and consistent fluid cleanliness levels. We are aware that the mobile filtration systems are not anything new, and they have been used to help our customers maintain fluid cleanliness for many years. What is new is that now you can add a Hytrax fluid sampling system right on your unit. Schroeder now offers the Hytrax Manual Fluid Sampling System as an additional option for your MFS or MFD mobile filtration system. This option allows for viewing ISO particle counts in real time on the Test Mate Contamination Monitor, the TCM, while filtering your fluid through the MFS or the MFD. You can either order this option with all brand new MFS or MFD mobile filtration systems, or purchase our retrofit option to add to your already existing mobile filtration system. In the next segment of this video, we'll show you how easy it is to install onto an already existing unit. With the Hytrax fluid sampling option for our mobile filtration systems, our users are now in complete control of their fluid cleanliness. Now that you know a little bit about our MFS and MFD mobile filtration systems with available Hytrax manual fluid sampling systems, we will show you 9 easy steps how you can add the Hytrax to your already existing system. As a note, this segment is only needed if you wish to purchase the retrofit option for an already existing system. You can also order brand new systems with this option already installed for you. To start, you will want to make sure that you have all the following items: a large straight slot screwdriver, small straight slot screwdriver, 8-inch wire ties, tape measure, wire cutters, 7/16 inch, half inch, and 9/16 inch wrenches, 2 large crescent wrenches, small crescent wrench. Once you have these items gathered, we can begin. Step 1. We will start by removing the filter cart suction hose from the intake strainer. To do this, we'll remove the 2 9/16 inch bolts that connect the motor to the pump. Both bolts are located directly underneath the AC motor shown here. Access is tight on the forward mounting bolts. You have to go from each side of the cart to fully loosen these bolts. An overhead lifting hoist can be used to raise the middle handle motor assembly. If a lift is not available, you will need two additional people to slightly lift the assembly to remove the forward bolt completely. Once the bolts are removed, you can detach a suction hose and set the handle motor assembly aside. Remember this step as we will have to reinstall the suction hose at the end of the retrofit process. Step 2. We will then install the two fittings and two hoses into the manifold as shown here. As a note, do not fully tighten the fittings into the manifold at this time. Once the fittings are loosely tightened, we can then tighten the hoses onto said fittings. When looking at the cart from the rear, the short hose, which is a TCM suction hose, attaches on the right-hand side. This hose will connect to the fittings closest to the cart pump and away from the filters. The long hose, which is a TCM discharge hose, will attach to the fittings closest to the filters on the left-hand side. Step 3. We'll then remove the four bolts holding the AC motor to the handle assembly. You may discard the bolts once removed. Now that the AC motor is off, we can now attach the Hytrax bracket to the handle assembly. Just carefully line up with the four holes. Then, we will grab the AC motor and place on top of the newly installed Hytrax bracket. Make sure this lines up with all four holes. The bolts included with the set can then be placed through the motor, Hytrax mount, and then mounted through the original motor mount plate. You should now have your original handle assembly, the new Hytrax bracket, and AC motor all connected. Check to make sure the motor is straight in reference to the cart handle. Step 4. We are now ready to install the overall handle assembly back onto the cart. During the installation, make certain that both sample hoses are routed through the top left opening on the Hytrax bracket and towards the backside of the system closest to the motor. Carefully align the motor shaft key with the pump shaft and key. The forward bolt will need to be started before setting the motor fully into the keyway. Tighten both the motor and the coupling bolts using a 9/16 inch wrench. Align the hose fittings so the hoses do not rub on the motor or the bracket. You may now tighten the newly installed manifold fittings using a 9/16 inch wrench. Connect the short TCM suction hose to the bottom port of the Hytrax manifold and the longer TCM discharge hose to the top port. Step 5. Cart motor power cable can now either plug into the newly installed Hytrax control panel or wire directly into the control panel. If you are not wiring directly into the motor, you may skip step 6. Step 6. We now need to shorten the existing AC motor cable. Measure 6 inches from the motor and then cut the cable. Strip the sheathing to expose 6 inches of wires and strip the ends. Route the power cables down under between motor and bracket as shown here. And back to the control panel as shown here. 110 VAC wire connections are shown here. Step 7. Feed the yellow sampling pump cable and black TCM power cable from the controller through the 1.5 inch hole in the bracket. Connect the sampling pump and the TCM power cords. Pay careful attention to align the tabs in the M12 connectors while making connections. We will then secure the cable and hoses with wire ties and reinstall the suction hose that we removed in step 1. The kit comes with two push button bleed fittings. Unscrew the bleed fitting located on each filter cap and install said fittings. Step 8. You are now ready to operate your cart. Please fully read the user's manual before operating your new Hytrax filter cart. To operate, place a wand into a reservoir and power up the cart using the switch mounted to the motor. Bleed the filter housing of air and allow the cart to operate for 5 minutes. Check each fitting for leaks and tighten if leaks are noticed. Step 9. After 5 minutes of the main pump operating, the Hytrax can be powered on using a switch manifold to the control panel. The pressure gauge mounted to the Hytrax manifold should rise to approximately 80 to 100 PSI. To verify flow rates, press the right arrow key until the TCM flow light is activated under the flow setting. Confirm flow rate is OK- or OK. The flow control valve located on the Hytrax manifold can be adjusted to obtain an OK- flow rate reading. Counterclockwise adjustment lowers flow rate. Clockwise adjustment raises the flow. Once flow rates are set to OK-, scroll left to visually see current ISO code readings. As a note, all of these steps and information previously mentioned is also included in our MFD MFS Hytrax Insulation Guide, which is our literature sheet L4534. An MFS MFD mobile filtration system for Schroeder Industries supplements continuous filtration by system filters and now provides real-time ISO contamination readings for use in cleaning up a hydraulic system following component replacement, filtering new fluid before it is put into service, or transferring fluid from storage tanks and drums to system reservoir. We hope this video has been helpful to you. Should you have any further questions or like more information on how the mobile filtration system with Hytrax can be of assistance to you, please contact us at sisales@schroederindustries.com.
Whether it's a helpful how-to or a new product release, Schroeder Industries is your place for fluid filtration. Subscribe below